Hi everyone, success is achieved and maintained by those who try and keep trying. So keep trying until reach your goal. By saying this, let us start your mathematics class. In this session, we are going to discuss the new topic, that is fractions. You have learnt in the previous session regarding fractions and you have heard the word fractions. Then what is meant by fraction? How the fractions will take place? How you are going to represent the fraction and what are the parts of the fraction? Everything you are going to learn in this session. Before going to the actual topic, let us consider few examples. Children, you know that you know about circle. Let us take one circle. You can observe here. This is the shape of circle. Now I have taken one whole circle. This is whole one circle. Now what I will do? I will make this circle into 4 equal parts. How many equal parts I will make? I am going to make this circle into 4 equal parts. 4 equal parts I have made. Now you can observe here. Now from this circle I require one part. I want to remove one part from this 4 parts. What I will do then? I will take out this one part. I will take out this one part. Then how you are going to represent this one as in the number? You know that for example if you take whole. Whole means for example, if you are considered, count the number of this pen and represent in the by using numbers, then easily you can represent there are 3 pens are there in my hand. Easily you can count and you can represent. By come to this, how you are going to represent this figure in the number? Then you can observe here how, for example, children, how many equal parts you have made? You have made 4 equal parts. From that, how many part you have selected? You have selected one part. Then, how you are going to represent by using number? One part I have selected. Out of how many number of parts? Out of 4 equal part. I have selected one part. Out of how many parts? Out of 4 equal part. Then next, let us take another one figure. Here, and I will take triangle. What is this? Triangle. You are so much familiar with the shape triangle. Now you can observe here. I have divided this triangle into 2 equal part. How many equal part I have divided? You can observe here. I have divided into 2 equal part. From these 2 equal part, I required how many part? I will take one part out. I will take one part. I will shade one part. Then how we are going to represent this by using numbers? Very easy. You can observe here. I have taken one part. Out of how many part? Out of 2 equal part. Out of 2 equal part. Here you can observe here. The upper part. Upper part represent what? Number of selected part. The below part represent what? Number of total number of part. Here you can observe here. The 1 represent is what? Number of part I have selected. 2 represent what? Total number of parts I have divided the whole part. Then easily you can understand the meaning of fraction. That is, a fraction is a number of selected part out of total number of parts. A fraction is a number of selected part out of total number of part. For example, you can observe here. I have taken the rectangle. You can observe here. I have divided the rectangle into 4 equal parts. Among that, 2 parts I have shaded. Then how you are going to represent by using number? 2 parts I have shaded out of 4 parts. Then 2 by 4 we can represent. In the same way, next figure you can observe here. Here also I have shaded one part. Then how you are going to represent? By 1 by 2. Then fraction is a part of whole. Fraction is a what? Part of whole. You have to take the whole figure and from that figure you are going to divide and then you are going to represent what? Fractions. To rewrite a fraction we need 2 numbers. You can observe here. Here also we have written, we have taken how many numbers? 2 numbers. Upper one number and below one number. Even here also, few examples you can observe here. 1 by 4, 1 by 2. Here how many numbers we have used? We have used 2 numbers. So, we need 2 number to represent what? Fraction. The number of equal parts into which the whole is divided forms the denominator. Now you can observe here, denominator, we have divided this whole figure into 4 equal parts. That total number of parts represent what? Denominator. Total number of parts represent what? Denominator. For example, in 3/4, you can observe here in 3/4, 4 is a denominator. 4 is a what? Denominator. 4 we are going to call what? Denominator. Then the number of equal parts selected or shaded. The number of equal parts selected or shaded forms the numerator. You can observe here in 4/9, 4 is a numerator. The upper part, the number of selected part, what you are going to select, that parts we are going to represent at the numerator. Then by this what we came to know that fraction is nothing but a number of selected part out of total number of part. Fraction means what? Number of selected part out of total number of part. So fraction is equal to numerator by denominator. Numerator represent what? Number of selected part. Denominator represent what? Total number of parts. Denominator represent what, children? Total number of part. So I hope everyone understood the meaning of fraction in detail. In the next class we are going to learn regarding fraction, still more concept. If you have any doubt, you can ask children. Thank you. Bye bye.